I think that great science starts with curiosity. Because, you know, what, there's no easy problems. And so what keeps you going, right? I mean, it's curiosity. You just have to really wonder what the answer is. And I think that drives the creativity and the, you know, the perseverance and hopefully the rigor as well. You know, I think science is beautiful. Yeah, I mean, what is more beautiful than, you know, discovering something that has never been known before? That's just sort of awe-inspiring. I mean, you know, maybe that's the same experience people get when they go to a museum and say they see a beautiful piece of art. I never get that experience, by the way. I'm art blind, but science, I mean, that's just, you know, the most amazing experience. You know, those few times in your life when you're, you know, there's some question that you've been working away on, and then all of a sudden, something new, you know, you figure out it's pretty, that's beauty. I mean, to me, the thing about having a terminal disease is, you know, everybody knows they're going to die at some point. But to me, the thing that's the hardest part is that this amazing time I've been having in science for my whole life just suddenly comes to an end, that I can't, you know, there are all these questions I'm curious about, and I would be hiring new students. I was about to take 5 new students in postdocs when I got sick, and I just told them all not to come. And, you know, they were going to be doing really interesting things. And it just, you know, it's just a curiosity, you know, that kills my curiosity. I was just curious about certain things, and it just, you know, comes to a halt, and that's frustrating. To me, that's the most frustrating. I'm not worried really about dying. I mean, everybody's going to die at some point. I'm old. I've had a great life. But it's kind of, that's the thing I think of, you know, sometimes, ah, damn, you know, I'd love to put a person on hepatic encephalopathy right now, because I think these A1 reactive astrocytes may be relevant. And I can think of some really great experiments that, you know, somebody could do some pilot experiments and see there's something there. But I, you know, oh, can't do that. Can't take new people. So that's the frustrating part.